I'll start with a story. Above the Crystal Restaurant here, the Lalanda family was living here. The mom and three children were here. And the day of the tornado, they all crashed through to the first floor where they were living above the restaurant. And there, what came after? So the two children climbed out, started looking for mom, couldn't find her. Another family scooped them up and kept them overnight. Sometime in the night, mom climbed out, but she couldn't find her kids. So she wandered Broadway all night looking for them. And then 8 a.m., the sun's come out. The next day, she is reconnected with her two children. The search continues for the third child. Fortunately, that child didn't make it. But then in the days after, they needed to hold a funeral. What do you do? That at the time, it was customary to hold your funeral in your home. What do you do if you don't have a home? So another family that they had never met said, you can have your funeral in our living room. And so they welcomed them into their home, and they did held that there. So that's a really heavy story to start off with. About the tornado, but ultimately it embodies the horror and the tragedy. But look, a family took care of those kids who didn't have a place to stay and were probably scared. And then another family said, you can have your funeral in our living room. And so it embodies this community that came out of everyone becoming neighbors after the tornado and helping one another. So ultimately, we're going to be talking a lot about the worst day in a lot of people's lives, but then how the community came together. What did you do? What did they do after the tornado? And how do you recover in a horrific tragedy like this? So the tornado, it struck June 28th, 1924. It hit first at Sandusky. It came ashore on Sandusky and then moved east. It jumped kind of over the lake and landed back in Lorain just after 5 o'clock at Lakeview Park. And then it did continue on east. So I was looking to see if we have any pictures of Avon Lake. I don't have any tornado pictures of Avon Lake, but I do have damage in Avon. So we know the tornado moved east after leaving Lorain. We know that it was considered an F4 tornado. They didn't have the Fujita scale back then, but based on pictures of the tragedy, for example, it could toss streetcars on their sides. And being able to toss trains is an example of the speed and power of an F4, which is 160 some to 200 miles per hour. So not the strongest tornado to have hit Ohio, but it is the deadliest tornado in Ohio's history. 72 people lost their lives. Okay. So I mentioned it struck first in Lorain at Lakeview Park, and it came quickly. You know, there was no warning signs back then other than you saw the storm coming, and so folks ran to the bathhouse. So this is the bathhouse after being destroyed. This is looking at it from the lake, and then you can see the arches here are still a part of the bathhouse today. So folks ran into the bathhouse. I think 8 people lost their lives in the bathhouse. And then it moved east through the neighborhoods, damaged a lot of homes along the way, snapped a lot of trees. We see those a lot in pictures. This is West Erie. This home here on the corner of West Erie and South Lakeview, it's still standing. If you're driving down to Lakeview Park, you'll recognize this gray building on the left because of these white arches that are still over the windows. So Lakeview's somewhere over here, and so then it kind of came down through this area. Reed Avenue is somewhere in here. A lot of churches received damage, and then this is Broadway here. So a lot of damage throughout this whole area. So one story of that I'll pause on is the Van Dusen household. It's really the Van Dusen and Richards family. This home has the unfortunate distinction of being the home with the highest number of deaths. Margaret Richards was visiting her brother at the Van Dusen, her brother-in-law at the Van Dusen house here in Lorain. So extended family came up from Columbus the day of the tornado. We're staying in the home, and I will read you an account from one of the sons. Richard Van Dusen, he was about 10, I think, at the time of the tornado. He gave this account in 1995. "It has been almost 75 years since the Lorain tornado destroyed our house at 1128 Fifth Street. Of the 10 people in our house at that time, I'm the only one still living today. Five of the 10 in our home were killed by the tornado." So Richard lost a younger sibling, but then his cousin who was in town, Margaret Richards, she lost her mom, her dad, and her two siblings. So she had to go back to Columbus alone. Richard says, "I remember my Uncle Ray saying, 'It looks like a bad storm is coming. I am glad I am not out on the road.' Mother heard the great door to the basement banging and asked me to close it. I was going back to tell my mother that the door would not close when my father called for everyone to go to the basement. Dad was holding the door for all to go down the steps when the house collapsed. Of those that were in the stairway, every other one of us in line was killed, either struck by falling timbers or suffocated by falling plaster. It was after midnight when the rescuers got us all out. Dad and I were taken to the Lorain High School building, which was used as an emergency center. I remember someone coming up and spoke to me where I was laying on the floor with some other injured. I later heard this person say, 'This one's still living. You better move him over there.' Dad and I were later taken on the bed of an old Ford truck to Elyria Memorial Hospital." So this home, the Van Dusen home, it did not survive the tornado. This is the home that was built in its place. And kind of interesting, this family, the Richards Van Dusen family, they held kind of like, they called it a house reunion, but about 20 of them came to Lorain this summer for the centennial commemoration at Lakeview Park. A lot of them had never been to Lorain before. Some of them, they took planes, they drove from all over the country. Somebody flew in from France to be here to find out what happened to their family, because that daughter was 13 years old and she went back to Columbus. And so then she had this story of the tornado, and her kids and grandkids wanted to know where their mom was at when that tornado struck. So we were really honored to have that family in Lorain this summer and to meet them and find out this legacy of the tornado and how it is still impacting the community today.